Thanks, guys. Next, Park Locator, next on deck, Price Gouging. Hi, so I'm working on a Park Locator application. The problem that is trying to be solved is that there are a lot of parks that exist in North Carolina and elsewhere, but they're actually more difficult to find than you would think they are. Mostly because the information is, in a lot of cases, really dispersed over a lot of different areas. So you've got municipal parks run by cities, you've got state parks that are run by the state, you've got county parks that are run by the county, and each of these things are all kind of siloed separately. So you can search the city for its parks or the county for its parks, but they don't share a data set. So, and even if you just like run Google, it's not always helpful. So for example, I ran this Google search earlier right here, and more than half of the things on the screen are not parks. It's a lot of extra data, it's a lot very confusing, and it's kind of hard to figure out what is what and where you should be going. So the solution is a Park Locator web application that can be a mobile-first solution that you can open up in your phone. It'll take in your location and let you know which parks are close to you, and in addition to that, what activities those parks have. So you can do a search by activity, do a search by distance, and on top of that have additional information like where the greenways are that connect different things. So if you want to start at one park and take the greenway to another park, you can see that that is an option. So there is some existing code that people have worked on this before. Specifically, the city of Raleigh built out a park locator for that jurisdiction. So it covers pretty much just the city of Raleigh and has all the county and state parks and Raleigh city parks within that data set. So this is a screenshot from that. And in addition, it has this activity picker little blip where you can click on this and it'll highlight which parks have those activities. And I have actually expanded on that already to include all of the data set from Wake County to have all the parks from Wake County, which I realize now that you cannot see because it's on the other screen. It looks something like this. So this includes all of Wake County as opposed to just the city of Raleigh. I didn't do that today, but that is something that I've worked on. So the restriction with this right now is that it doesn't... So that solution is good, but it's not extended, meaning it's only for the city of Raleigh, and it's pretty hard-coded to grab from the city of Raleigh. It doesn't grab from anywhere else. And I had to switch some of the hard-codings to get that to work for Wake, for the entire Wake County. As I was mentioning, there is a lot of open data in this space. Wake County has provided a very large data set. Durham has a data set, probably somewhere. Sam's nodding, so that's always a good sign. There is something in some of Chris's documentation about a data set from the town of Cary. There is interest from Greensboro that I've heard expressed, so I think there's a lot of open data to be found and used. And really the goal is to expand this out so that we can easily add additional functionality and additional municipalities and regions to this, to a single location. So you can go to one site and find parks regardless of where you are. So this is some of the impacts, is parks can be easier to find. You can find new parks or find parks that do activities that you want. So if you want to go frisbee golfing, you just highlight all the frisbee golfing things within 20 miles and you'll see all of your options. And one of the biggest things is it goes across the borders. It's not just Wake County or Durham County or anything like that. It's continuous wherever the municipalities have added their data.
So, just two questions. So, are we arguing, are we proposing a consumer-driven thing where the public is able to find this?
Yes.
Or are you, so we're not necessarily talking about the other side where staff might have a consistent dumping place for all this data?
I think in the ideal case, it would be something of both. I didn't get to it in the slides, but some of the future features, like MVP, would allow for user tracking and adding comments. So like if you have a park that you want to go fishing at and somebody can post a comment saying, hey, this is where you go in the park to go fishing, as opposed to just, oh, this park is fishing. And allow for feedback from park users to the actual government saying, hey, here, you know, this trail needs to be fixed or something like that. So really could work on both levels, where users can find, or people can find parks that they want to go to, and then provide feedback that can be filtered back to the stakeholders in those parks.
One question I have, and I, because I've experienced it often with the park, and then really also greenways and trails data, is it's on a portal, but it's not updated. And so thinking about the feedback loop of someone using it, and using outdated information, how do you handle that? And how do you use the communication process with each jurisdiction, or how does that work?
Right. That's a great question and a great concern. I do not have all the answers at this point in time. I think allowing for that feedback, that customer feedback to happen and say, hey, this is out of date, allows for that communication to happen and allows basically feedback to go to the government and say, hey, you need to update X, Y, and Z so that we can get the more recent version of this that's accurate. But how precisely that will work, we'll lay out in the cards later.
So for this, do you currently envision that a bunch of developers or a bunch of people are going to work on making sure that the data is important to the back end, accessible to folks? How does this scale as more and more people use the app?
Right. So what is in plan right now is to build out a back end that will keep a list of where all that information is stored from those municipalities. And